just do
sure
trimming, so from the beginning and end.
Hi, so today we're going to test a Google form to see some accessibility issues and some really good things that I've done with error handling. When I say error handling, I'm talking about how to convey that there is an error to a screen reader user. I'm going to refresh this
page. Dialogue, this page is asking you to confirm. Leave page button, space.
Because I already have some data test in here.
Test form document read only focused. Heading level 1 test form. List with 3 items. Heading level 2, are you afraid of the big bad wolf?
Kind of a funny question, but if I tab into it.
List. Are you afraid of the big bad wolf? Star grouping required. Yes, radio button not checked, 1 of 3.
See, it reads the error, it says required. That's just kind of state information. I'm going to leave that unrequired for now.
What is your name? Edit invalid entry required. Blank.
See if I just go and submit the form.
Out of list submit button. List. Alert, this is a required question.
It says this is a required question. They're using alerts, so it did interrupt the focus being set to the question itself.
What is your name? Are you afraid of the big bad wolf? Star grouping invalid entry required. Yes, radio button checked, 1 of 3.
I select yes here.
What is your name?
Go
edit invalid entry required.
Field and type
blank.
B.
Alert, please enter your first name, last name, separated with spec.
I'm supposed to say space, but I failed at that. The problem here is if I type another character.
Alert, please enter.
It reads the alert again.
B. Space. Alert, please enter your first name. J. O. E.
So I put Bob Joe as my name. You notice as soon as I put a space and then J, and the error was gone, it stopped giving me the error. I'm going to remove the error, or the whole thing.
Bob Joe selected E.
And I'm just going to put
J-O-H-N. Alert, please enter your first name, last name, separated with spec.
John.
List with 3 items, please enter your first name, last name, separated with spec.
I went into browse mode and pressed down arrow to show that I can actually see the error text as a screen reader user, not in focus mode. So the error text should not be hidden so that I can actually read it character by character if I want.
L-E-A-S-E space E-N-T-E-R.
I was just showing you that I can read it by character. Okay, I'm going to move back to the edit field.
What is your name? Blank, blank, blank. Test form dash my John. John, blank, blank, N-N-N, blank, space, alert, S-M-I-T-H.
So I put John Smith in there.
Month combo box collapsed editable. Blank.
So that question is required.
Day of the out of list submit button.
Submit and show that it puts focus on it.
Alert, this is list. Month combo box collapsed editable. Blank.
It said this is a required question, and the alert actually cut off the announcement of the question again, and the question cut off the alert. So sometimes having alerts like that can cause problems. So if you can mix the error into the label, it might actually help. There's another accessibility issue with this question, and I'll show you here. If I press up arrow to select
01 02 blank 04
April
day of the month combo box collapsed editable,
and I pressed enter to select April, which is the standard way of actually selecting something in a comma box. If I were to do alt down here after I press tab, it doesn't actually say expanded.
01 02 03 04 05 07 08.
I'll select April 8th.
Year combo 2016.
Let's pretend I'm 1 year old, just because I don't feel like pressing down arrow a bunch. Okay, I pressed enter on 2016. If I press tab to submit this
button.
What?
Submit button focused.
Yeah, there we go. The audio card cut off some of the audio there.
List. Alert, this is a required question.
You heard that it dropped me into
month combo box collapsed focused editable. 04.
I have something in there, but it says it's required.
Month combo box collapsed focused editable.
That's because Google, for some reason, doesn't confirm the selection unless I actually manually type it out. So let's say I type in
04. Day of the month combo box collapsed editable. Selected 08.
Let's try putting
2 characters
here.
Maximum. F-I-S-H. Year combo box collapsed editable. Selected 2016.
Let's try
4 characters maximum.
Cat in here.
C. A. T.
It doesn't actually tell me that there's an error.
Submit button.
But when I try to submit.
2 characters maximum. List. Alert, this is a required question. Month combo box collapsed focused editable. 04. 04. Day of the month combo box collapsed editable. Selected 08. 2 characters maximum.
2 characters maximum. So I'm going to put 08. 0.
Alert 8. Maximum of 2 characters entered.
And it told me that I entered 2 characters.
Year combo 6. Alert. Blank. Blank.
If I were to put fish in here.
F. I. S. H.
There is no error given, though.
List with 3 items invalid date. Out of list button submit.
But it does say invalid date there.
List. Alert invalid date. Month combo box collapsed focused editable. 2 care. Year combo. Year combo box collapsed focused editable. Blank.
Let's do
2000. Submit button.
And now that I've actually manually entered it all, it should submit.
Test form. Your response has been recorded. Links.
So, you see, once there are no more errors, it allows you to submit. But doing a date picker with the error conditions is fairly complicated.